Australia is known for having some of the most remote locations in the world, from sprawling deserts to untouched beaches. And joining us this morning is a guy who's been almost every corner of this amazing country. It's All for Adventure host Jase Andrews. Welcome, Jase. Thank you for joining us. Now, where did this passion of yours come from?
Look, it all started when I was a little kid, and a lot of people could probably relate to that, you know what I mean? Like, when you're a little kid, I think you were just telling me about your son, you know?
My son's mad for catching skinks. I was asking the technique. There's no technique.
No. Yeah. Just catch them.
It all started from being a little kid, and I just want to go out into the bush, and I spent a lot of my time growing up in the bush and on farms and things like that, and all I wanted to do was just go further and further and wider and, you know...
And now with the show you have.
Yeah.
But let's face it, Australia's a big country. Is there any place you really want to go to that you haven't gotten to yet?
So I really started to expand my horizon, so to speak, when I got my car license, you know. Yeah. It was like freedom. And I started driving across Australia. Like, I'd been across like 11 times.
Please tell me you didn't drive like that though.
No, but I just started expanding, you know, the places that I went. And so for the last 30 years, it's Australia is a big place, but it starts to sort of get smaller and smaller. Mm. But there are so many places I haven't been.
Really?
Yes.
Well, what about out of the places you've been, where's like the must go before I die place?
Well, you're going to know this one, the Kimberley.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
It's not a go before I die.
Go while I'm, you know, wanting to experience.
Every time I go there, all I want to do is go back there. Really? And I've been to places in the Kimberley that, you know, and I can't say this for certain, but quite possibly the first person to put a foot there.
Wow.
As in a white person.
So what you're saying is that you've been to paradise. Have you been to me?
But it is a sacred place, isn't it? Yeah. Is that it's got a special... I know Nicole Kidman spoke about it when she filmed Australia there. And
yes.
She conceived there.
Yeah. Look...
Something in the water.
Yeah, something in the water. It's a very spiritual place. And there's one little thing that I found an actual burial site in the Kimberley, which wasn't registered because we checked it out, and I couldn't believe that we'd stumbled. I thought, yeah, tourists would be there all day long.
That's amazing.
But we found an Aboriginal burial site in the Kimberley, and I thought, oh, you know, surely. And we did a lot of research on it, and yes, it wasn't registered. People didn't know about it.
Incredible. Wow. Jase, All for Adventure has been 10 years in the making.
Yeah.
Got another 10 years in you?
Oh, hell yeah. Seriously.
Yeah,
like,
good.
The thing about All for Adventure is people have sort of, they resonate with it, and it's almost like they become, I don't know, they get so excited about what I do and where I go, and that sort of just fuels me, and I'm just like, I can't believe it. There are people and kids, a lot of kids get so passionate about it. Like, I got kids making Lego blocks of, you know, mimicking
that's,
me.
That's
and,
great. That's cool, man. That's
there,
really cool.
There are two kids sent in a photo. They'd cut the sleeves off their shirts, their school shirts, mind you, and their mum's just like...
I'd love that.
The kids and hate mail from the mums.
I
love adventurers.
Yeah.
I love from a kid, I watched Albie Mangles, who I think was a fraud.
Yeah.
And then Bear Grylls, who's always like, it's really hot out here, I'm probably going to die, it's really hot. And he's just a whinging pom. But that's... But you've seen some hardcore stuff. You get out there. What is the biggest challenge you faced? Out in the wild, really hot. What is it that you faced?
I can resonate with that because when he went to the Kimberley, all he did say was, it's hot here every minute. And it's like, I went to the Kimberley once and we recorded a temperature at 52 degrees sitting under the awning, you know, in this remote location, and you're just going, yeah, it's hot.
They have awnings up there. That's
I
great.
Put out an awning.
Have you ever drunk
your truck?
Have you ever drunk your own pee? Be honest.
No.
Or you've got
someone else's?
But having
we won't
said
go
that,
into that.
There's a little clip. They're probably watching a little clip now. See what's happening.
Oh, right, you've rolled it.
Yeah, oh. That would have to be one of the most exciting yet terrifying moments of the 10 years we've spent filming in Australia in the wild.
Well, that's a good segue, because talking about terrifying, you've got some friends with you this morning, and I'm, full disclosure, not coming over there with you, because I'm deathly, deathly afraid of big lizards, and I fear there may be one over there. So I'm going to sit as far back in my chair as I can and send you over with beautiful Susie and Joe.
You read ahead in the script.
See what she got.
Like, not in a funny... Really, oh, it'll be funny to... She doesn't like them.
Die. It's really hot.
Oh, I see python.
Yeah, there we go.
And I love that he's wearing thongs. I don't think we've ever had a guest on with flip-flops.
This looks a bit ominous. Oh, I get the grey ones.
Yeah, you get the grey ones. Mm. All right. You don't have to put them on if you want.
Yeah,
you
know, No, that's all right. Let's go with this one.
You want to go with python first?
Yeah.
All right, okay. Yeah. We're sweet.
Yeah, it's like a surprise.
All right, let's do it. Let's just do it.
Absolutely.
Look at that. You're good to go.
Hello, gorgeous.
Put that down there. Now, this is a 3-metre olive python.
Oh, it's only 3 metres. Yeah. It's bumsy.
All right, so we'll just look for the bitey end. You know the bitey end?
Yes. I do know that difference. But they don't really bite pythons, do they?
No, not really.
They're boa constrictors, so that they're more inclined. Oh, look at that.
Here we go. Now, it's quite...
Oh, divine. Where's your head, sweetheart?
There you go.
Hello,
look at
gorgeous.
That.
Hello.
Did you want to hold that end?
Oh, I'll put it all around me.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah. All good. Thank you.
There you go. There's a fashion accessory.
I just want to...
New fashion...
Oh, no, his head.
So what's in the middle one?
I'm scared. What's in this one?
All right, you good with that one?
I'm good, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Does that tongue not...
Good to go. We'll see where... Male or female?
I'm not sure, actually.
Okay. we'll know where it gets to.
All right, here we go.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh my god!
Oh, yeah. Oh, now this is so cute.
I think I'll get it.
It's actually kind of snake away from the crop.
Yes.
Oh my god!
Now get a firm grip. Get a firm grip.
Can't snap. He's got a band-aid.
That'll do a lot.
Is that going to hold? How old is this little one? He's actually quite cute. So cold.
Yeah. So obviously they're a reptile. You know, they need the warmth. They're like little solar panels when the sun comes out.
It kind of matches my outfit. I feel a bit.
Yes, it does. That's why he feels so.
No,
calm.
I'm very Peter friendly.
That's saltwater. Yeah. So that's quite
Australian
dangerous.
Saltwater crocodile. Ah. That thing. Look, seriously.
Even Jase is standing away.
Oh, don't do that.
Hold it tight. Hold it tight.
No, he's got
a band-aid.
That is like the cutest little...
Does this snake want to eat him?
Okay, what have you got in there?
I don't know. If we had a bit of a... Yeah.
It would be a Barney.
Oh, no, I reckon the snake would probably eat that, yeah.
Oh, really?
But look, this is you know, this is only a little pup.
Hello, sweetheart. You're all right.
So these grow to how big?
Well, you think about it. 5 metres.
Wow.
It could end up being 5 metres long.
Jesus. Okay.
And there was an incident just recently, and I don't know whether... They'll probably show the footage of it. But
it's moving.
A 4-metre crocodile.
Joe. No, you're what's not going one? Back in there. No,
came bolting down the bank and nearly ended up in the front of our tinny, our boat.
So, what's in the middle?
Oh, my God.
I think it wants to go back to you.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, we'll put,
we'll put
you away.
Gee, they've got some force to them, haven't they?
See that? See what he's doing there?
Here, do you want the lid?
Back in the box. This is so not like play school, is it? It's like...
Do you want to get your hand up? Good stuff.
Okay. Now,
all right, we're safe
I'm
in there.
Intrigued as well.
All right, you want to know what's going on with this one? All right, here we go.
Oh, that's it. You're not putting the gloves on.
Quite.
All right, here we go.
Oh. See, George is going to hate this one.
No,
she's got... You're good with no legs, but you're not good when a...
All right, now I'm not going to hand you this one. He's got...
Oh, really?
Yeah. He's a bit...
See, what?
Can't get it out.
Oh, my God. What's going on in there?
He wants to have a little look. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, he hasn't got it.
Is this a...
Oh, that's a...
So this is a monitor.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, like a goanna.
Oh, right.
Everyone's
right.
Probably familiar with a goanna.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And look, desert, you know, lives in the desert and
these
awesome.
Yeah.
Oh,
no.
The thing about it is, it's those feet. Look at those claws.
Oh, look at them. So yeah. They're just like.
That's why I've got him like this.
Right,
so
okay, I don't want to.
I can immobilise him and I can hold him.
Yeah.
But if I were to stick him like on my arm or my leg, first thing he's going to do, he's going to wrap those claws around me. Yeah, and he'll draw blood with the claws.
Oh, and really? They can scurry pretty fast.
Oh, yeah, they're very fast.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
To catch these guys in the wild, you've really got to... You've almost got to get them to go to the tree, and then you can get them off the tree, but if you try and sprint after them, no, forget it.
You are an absolute legend. And just a delight to have you here. Thank you so much, Jason. And you can catch more of Jase on All For Adventure, Sundays at 1 p.m. on 10 and, of course, Win TV. Or jump online to allforadventures.com. Jase, once again, thank you so much.
No worries. My pleasure. My pleasure, guys.
You're accessory.